focus to the automaker Maruti Suzuki, where today the company reported its numbers, and what a stellar set it has been for Maruti Suzuki, the numbers beating all the estimates that we had at ET now. And this time the revenue has seen a jump of almost 15% on a YOY basis. EBITDA saw a jump of almost 40% for the company. The margins also came in above our expectation at 11.7%, and profits zoomed 33% on a YOY basis. So good set, all-round beat coming in for Maruti Suzuki. But what's the way forward and what are the growth triggers that the company is looking forward to? Let's understand more from the management itself. And let me welcome Rahul Bharti, Executive Director at Maruti Suzuki. Hi, Rahul. A very good evening and thank you so much for your time. First of all, wanted to touch upon the margin figure of the company. Indeed, a better number than what the street was expecting, 11.7%. But that's a little low versus Q2 of FY24. We understand the reasons that there were discounts, the volumes were down because of the plant shutdown. But going ahead in Q4, are we in for some improvement in the margin figure?
Let me talk about the margin drivers. Cyclically, both Q2 and Q4 are quarters where wholesale exceeds retail. In quarter three, the retail is lower because we want to maintain very low year-end inventories. So going forward, yes, the quarter four wholesale should be much better than retail. We had a minor price increase of about 0.45% weighted average. That should help. There is some benefit accruing on account of commodities like platinum, palladium, rhodium. Of course, there's a minor impact of steel also. Forex, we had some advantage in Q3, and that advantage will continue in Q4 for our indirect exports, indirect imports also. So the margin drivers look positive with respect to Q3 in that sense.
So a push in the volumes could really give a push to the margins as well. But Rahul, touching on the CNG sales, this time the quarterly sales for the CNG were at a record high level. What are you penciling in for the Q4 in terms of the percentage contribution of CNG in the overall portfolio? And what's the outlook for FY25?
So you're right. We have achieved an all-time high penetration of above 30% in our CNG sales, and we expect it to continue. We hope that the CNG prices do not rise much because there is some concern on the APM. The APM price is fixed, but the quantities are gradually getting limited. So if that is not a risk, then CNG volume should continue. It's an excellent fuel for both CO2 reduction and customer economics, and we hope to increase our penetration in the future.
Forward to that, Rahul. Also wanted to understand the current waiting periods for some of the launches that you have done in the last couple of years, because the last whole year we have been just talking about the kind of waiting period that the customers had to suffer with. But as of now, what is the average waiting period for some of your recent launches from the likes of Jimny, Grand Vitara, Brezza, etc.?
So thankfully, the semiconductor crisis, which was a major reason of constraint, has gone. At least for now, we don't foresee such a challenge. Our waiting periods are quite manageable, so customers don't have to wait much. Only in CNG models, we have a bit of a constraint, which should go away with some time. So models are fairly accessible for our customers. They won't have to wait for long.
Okay, fairly accessible as of now. But Rahul, one of the companies collaborated with Maruti Suzuki as well as Suzuki Motor Corp is Toyota. And Toyota globally is facing some bit of a challenges in terms of the testing certification trouble, wherein for India, they have said that Toyota, Innova, Crysta, Fortuner, and some of the models have been kept on hold. But since you have a rebadging tie-up with Toyota, any impact that is there with this particular tie-up, or any impact on the sales that the company is penciling in? Wanted to have more clarity on this particular subject.
There's no impact to us at all.
All right. Thank you so much for this. But what's the outlook on the exports as well? Because exports too are at a record high level for Maruti Suzuki. In terms of the percentage contribution, Rahul, how do you see FY25 percentage contribution from exports going up for Maruti Suzuki, as well as which markets are opening up for you guys?
Yes, we have a very fantastic story in exports unfolding. We did about 270,000 in the every year. We hope to keep beating the past record. Even this quarter was the highest ever, 71,785 cars. By the turn of the decade, we hope to do about 750,000 to 800,000 exports. There are some markets which are getting very exciting. For example, Africa, within that South Africa. The Middle East has grown phenomenally in the past few months because of increased tourism. The government of India is also helping through some FTAs. We have an FTA with UAE. I think another one is being discussed with GCC, six countries. So that will help. And I think more products in more geographies with more distribution intensity, that will help. That will help our exports. Today, about 42% of India's exports are from Maruti Suzuki. And the best part is that EVs, our first EV, we will be exporting to Europe and Japan. Till now, EVs were a topic of imports. I think we'll be able to shift the topic to exports when it comes to EVs and to advanced markets like Europe and Japan this year itself, this calendar year.
All right. We look forward to that as well, Rahul. But lastly, wanted to touch upon the small car segment recovery as well, since you are sounding positive on the volume front. How are you seeing the next couple of quarters, that is Q4 of FY24 and Q1, the first half of this calendar year, panning out in terms of the recovery in the small car segment, as well as the SUV market share? What are the growth projections there?
So you're right, we are facing structural headwinds in the small car segment. I think that segment is challenged by affordability. There have been, the cost has gone up. Some entry level cars have been discontinued. So the entry price point has now shifted from, let's say, 250,000 rupees to 400,000 rupees. And we believe that not much can be done about the cost, but when income in that segment in the population of India, when it grows up, it catches up with the higher cost, the small car segment may come back with increased volumes. Currently, it is degrowing in both volume terms and percentage terms.
Okay, Rahul, thank you so much for giving us that clarity and the outlook for Maruti Suzuki in the times ahead. It was great having you. With this, we'll let you go on that.
Thank you.